In this module, we'll look at the tools to model data. We'll be looking in three areas. One, techniques we can run in Excel. Second, techniques we can run in Python. And techniques we can run in other tools. We'll start with Excel, where we'll be looking at correlation, regression, and outlier detection. Correlation is where we ask the question, how often do two variables move together? For example, if a student's writing an exam, how often does the student score high in physics when they also score high in mathematics? And if that happens often, then they're highly correlated. Regression answers the question, how much of a difference does it make? So, for example, if the student scores a 1 mark increase in mathematics leads to a 1 mark increase in physics, then that's a 1 unit regression. But if a 1 mark increase in chemistry leads to a 5 mark increase in physics, then if the student wants better marks in physics, they're probably better off studying more chemistry than mathematics because chemistry has a bigger impact. So how much of an effect is answered by regression? How often is there an effect is answered by correlation? Outliers answer the question, when does this fail? So are there students who score really high in mathematics but who score really poor in physics? That's what we'll be looking at. And all three will be using an example with COVID data. Next, we'll be looking at Python, where we'll look at the techniques of classification, how we run forecasting, and how we do clustering. Classification is where we ask the question, a given data point, which group does it belong to? For example, if there is a bank that is looking to decide whether this person should be given a loan or should not be given a loan, based on all the past data, a classification algorithm can look at that history of data and say, looking at the profile of this person, I would put them in the give the loan bucket or put her in the don't give the loan bucket. Forecasting is where we make a prediction. Let's say there is a time series. We are looking at stock prices historically, and we want to answer the question, what is this stock price going to be in the future? Looking at all of the other stocks in the same industry, for example, or its own stock price in the past. This may happen because there is seasonality. This may happen because there is a trend. This may happen because other variables are influencing a given variable. But forecasting is where we are predicting something in the future. Clustering is where we are grouping things. Are certain stocks very similar to each other in the sense that when one goes up, the other goes down? It's kind of like clustering, but with multiple variables where we answer the question, can we group things into similar entities? We'll be using different data sets for these examples in Python. And then we'll go on to three other tools. R and RStudio are very popular tools for data modeling. And apart from Excel and Python, this is perhaps the most commonly used tool. We'll also be covering a specific tool called Rattle. Rattle is a non-programmatic R-based application that can help you analyze data without needing to learn R or Python or any other language. PyCaret is a similar tool on Python, which helps you build models and explore models fairly quickly. And more importantly, it automatically builds models for you and allows you to pick and choose which are the better ones. In all, what you'll be learning is a variety of different tools and specific techniques on these tools that you can use to build models on data. And the purpose of the models is basically to help us understand something about them that is not obvious by just looking at the data.